Hey guys, in this tutorial, we're going to go over how to do bulk edits. What is a bulk edit? A bulk edit is basically making changes to more than one item. Sometimes, if you have a lot of rules or a lot of profiles and you want to make changes to multiple items, it's going to be faster doing it this way, the way I'm about to show you, than to do it through the options page. All right, let's begin. First, you'll need to install VS Code if you don't already have it. You can go here to download it. I'll put a link in the description below. Once you have it installed, start it up. It'll look something like this. We're going to export the default data set and use that as a template. So go to the sync tab, export, save the CSV in VS Code, open it. We're going to wipe out all the data because we're going to start from a clean slate. Everything that starts with C, those are profiles. Let's remove all the profiles. Everything that starts with R, those are rules. Let's remove all the rules. Everything here, this is data for the different tabs, advanced, exceptions, text clips, variables, and everything starting from this row on are the options in the settings tab. We'll leave this section alone for now. We're not going to work with it, so. Go ahead and save. Go back here, import it. Review the data. You should see that there should be no more rules and no profiles. Confirm by hitting save. Now let's do some bulk editing operations. And you'll see how fast it is using this technique. First thing you need to do is you need to install an extension, a VS Code extension. Click on this icon here, extensions, search for SEQ. This is what you want to install, VS Sequential Number. I've already got it installed, so go ahead and install it. Okay, so first thing we're going to do is, let's say we want to add a bunch of profiles. We're going to add a bunch of dummy profiles. Go ahead and enter a bunch of empty lines. And then we're going to go into a multi-line editing mode. To do that, hold down Control Alt. It might be different for Macintosh. Control Alt and down arrow key. You should see now you have a very tall caret. Go down to the last empty line. And we can begin typing. And as we type, it will make changes to all the lines where you see the caret. So these are the column headers. We're going to use this as a guide. The first column is profile ID. That has to be unique and it needs to start with a C for profile. So we're going to type C. And then we're going to bring up the command palette. To bring up the command palette, hold down Control Shift P. And then search for the command sequential number. Hit enter. We're going to start the numbering at one, so hit enter again. See how cool that is? Now you have a bunch of unique profile IDs entered for you. Let's continue. Type comma. Next column is name. Let's call these dummy profile, and we'll use the sequential numbers again. Control Shift P. The last use command is already there for you, highlighted for you. Hit enter. Enter, starting at one. There you go. Let's continue, comma. Next column is site. We'll leave that empty. Next column is hotkey. We'll leave that empty. And two more empty columns. To get out of multi-line editing mode, hit escape. Control S to save. From here, let's re-import the CSV. Review the data. Now you have a bunch of dummy profiles. That was pretty fast, right? Now let's say we want a bunch of dummy rules now. It's a similar technique. Add a bunch of empty lines in the rules section. Go into multi-line editing mode. Control Shift down arrow. Or my bad, Control Alt down arrow. Start typing. The rule ID, similar to the profile ID, needs to be unique, but this time it needs to start with the letter R. Bring up the command palette, Control Shift P, sequential number starting at one. And then let's continue. Next column, comma, type. The type is an index starting with zero. And the first type is text. So we're going to make it a text field. Name. For now, just enter a name. Value. Enter value. Site. Leave it empty. Mode. Leave it empty. And profile. Leave it empty. Actually, you can't leave the profile empty or else it'll be unfiled. So for profile, let's put it in C1. Oops. Get out of multi-line editing mode. So this column here is site. This column here is mode. This column here is profile. Yep, I just wanted to verify. Now all these rules will be in profile C1. This profile right here. Save, import. Review the data. Save. Yep. See how fast that was to add a bunch of dummy rules to one profile? Now let's say you want to move all of these rules to profile 10. So let's see what the ID is for profile 10. The ID is C10. So to do that is even easier. You just do a global search and replace. But since we only want to make the changes to the rules, you want to do a global search, not a global, but a search and replace in the text selection only. So to do that, highlight all the rules, hit Control H for search and replace. Make sure that you're in this mode, find in selection. It's going to give you a preview of what it found. We want to change C1 to C10. And click replace all or hit Control Alt Enter. Save, Control S. Let's re-import the data. Now all the rules should have moved to profile 10. See how easy that was to move a bunch of rules from one profile to another? That's pretty much bulk editing. You can use the same technique to do a bunch of other types of edits, like renaming profile names, renaming any value you want by doing global search and replace. Let's say we want to rename dummy profile to test profile. It's as simple as search and replace. I always want to enable these two to be on the safe side. This is a match case and match whole words only. Save, re-import. Review the data. All of our profiles have been renamed. You can use a multi-line editing mode to add a prefix to the profile. Let's say I want to organize these profiles into a submenu. Here's one thing you can do. To do a, to show render these as a submenu, you need to go into this into the settings tab and enable group profiles by categories. Make sure you select this. Once this is enabled, this selection here, the profile names will, they can take a category similar to this syntax, similar to the text clip syntax. So you can use our technique that we covered earlier to add a prefix. So we're essentially adding up a category. So I'm going to put sample. Like that. Save it, re-import. So now this profile should be rendered inside this subcategory in the context menu. Let's save it. No, I think I know why, because when we re-imported, we overrode the settings. Let's go back and change it to group profiles by category. There you go. Sample. You can have as many levels of categories and subcategories as you want by adding more levels here, similar to this. And this concludes the tutorial for today. Until next time.